Salaam alaikum. Haroon Yahya gets 1,000, and check out the number. I couldn't help but laugh at it, especially the number at the end. He gets 1,075 years plus 3 months. And the 3 months, it had me laugh. It's just a really professional, you know, the way it's written, and 3 months, subhanAllah. But any, it's really a reminder, you know, and for all of us, the fact that this man, who many people took as a resource, as you know, as a reliable resource that you would go back to when it came to, you know, the scientific miracles and what have you. You know, I was approached several times by his team to work with him to do some filming, but I just wasn't relaxed to these people. I didn't, you know, and he wasn't someone adhering to the Quran and the Sunnah, so I'm not going to put my name with his name and my work with his work. And sure enough, then he started to become stranger and stranger. And the things that he was doing, I was reading this morning. It was interesting because what they were mentioning, him by his real name, which I had no idea what his real name is Adnan Oktar or something like that. So they're mentioning by his real name. I'm like, who is this dude? This is like a freak. This guy, right? And he's got all these women in bikinis, and he's this religious figure. It didn't even cross him. And then when I start to read this, and he calls them his cats and women in bikinis and famous religious figure, I said, is that him? So I put it on Google, the real name, and sure enough, it's Haroon Yahya, subhanAllah al-Azim. You know, and this just shows us when someone who's not adhering to the Quran and the Sunnah, and someone who gives in and follows the lust and the desires, what it can lead you to and how astray you actually can go. And therefore, if we want to stay safe, as Imam Malik said, he said that the Sunnah, he said it's like Safinat Nuh, it's like the ark or the ship of Noah, alayhi salam. And he said, whoever gets on it, he'll be safe. And whoever refuses to get on, that he's going to drown. And this is why our scholars focus so much on looking at who you take your religion from. They used to say, "Inna hadha al-ilm dinun," that indeed this ilm, this knowledge is deen, it's from the religion. "Fanzuru amman ta'khuduna dinakum." So look closely to those who you take your deen from. Before we trust someone and we take from their knowledge, we have to see where did they obtain their knowledge from? What are the sources? Who are those they took from? Did they take from the trustworthy scholars who adhere to the Quran and Sunnah? Or did they take from the people of bid'ah, the people of innovation? Or did they take from books? Some so-called scholars in the English language, wallahi, they don't even speak Arabic. How can you be a scholar? How can you even be a student of knowledge if you don't speak the language of the Quran and of the Sunnah? Therefore, don't be fooled. Look very closely who you take your knowledge from. And this is a great example of what can happen to someone who doesn't have proper knowledge from the Quran and from the Sunnah and hasn't taken the knowledge from the correct sources. What can happen to them? May Allah protect all of us. May Allah keep our hearts firm upon the religion. And may Allah help us to be from those who strive to hold firm and to adhere to the Sunnah of our beloved Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the ones who live on it and the ones who die on it.